Hello guys, welcome back. Today I'm going to show you my plants. You can see here, it's tomatoes. And the way I nursed it, it's so chopped up. You can see, it's so chopped up. So I see that it's not going to do well. And today I decide to separate them because it's so chopped up. You can see I have my ground here. This is my soil bought from the shop, and I'm going to do it straight away. I do this. I fill all the containers with soil. Quick and fast. And when I'm done filling with soil in the containers, I'll go straight to start separating the tomatoes actually. And if you let it, it will never do well like that because it's so close to each other. You have to separate it to make space so it can grow up nicely. And there. Here I have put in the soil, and I'm just going to make a hole at the middle of each where I will now dip the plant. I'll just make holes with my fingers, and I use this. You don't pull it up like this. When you pull it up, you root it off like this. It's not going to work. Can you see? It has cut. So you have to use this stuff here. You take it from the root and you pull it up like this. Makes it easier. Can you see the roots are there? Now you do not want to cut it, the top from the root, so you go like this. You see there, and you go straight to the little holes that you had prepared, the middle of the of each. You just put it in there, and you do same for all of them. You do same for all. So what I'm doing now, I'm just basically transplanting. Because it's growing too chopped up. I do this. And it's not one each. I put some glue, about 3-4. Maybe 5 sometimes. It can go. We're just trying to separate it. This also helps it more because you're using the original, the soil that the plant has been growing with, meaning the soil the plant recognizes. So you're not just taking it off from its natural habitat. But you're basically transplanting it to a more spacious environment. You can see there. You do this. And I do the same thing. All of it. And yeah, it's going. You just have to be very careful and do not worry. You're not going to do all of them very successfully. Some are definitely going to fall by the wayside. They're not going to survive. But yeah, that is it. It's fine. shut up. Taking more of it. It looks like somewhere even growing underneath others. But yeah, this is what happens in the course of planting, because you just throw the seeds and so I do this, fill it up with the ground. Remember, it's just transplanting. Make sure it has its same ground that it has germinated from. If not, the plant will get confused with the new ground you're putting it in, and it might end up dying. And yeah, this also helps, because if the plant is growing leggy, you'll now fit it in nicely for it to grow correctly. And it's also easier like this when you want to do the final planting. You just pull it off from here and put it to the ground. So that's it, guys. You can see for yourself. It's gone. And when I'm done with this, I'm just going to throw some water to water the plants. And then I put it in a very warm environment. If not, it wouldn't survive. Has to be warm. So you know, it's kind of fun with the lockdown. Remember I told you, when you stay indoors, you can go anywhere. You can do this for fun. You can do planting. And I can't wait to see these crops grow in my garden. The Butanga, Pari Butanga garden. And yeah, do not worry, I'll keep on updating you. The latest developments, how the plants are doing. You'll get to know it all. That are left, I just leave them there. Okay guys, here we go, almost done, almost done. When you do this, you're sure to have some nice tomatoes And if you do not separate them like this, you might not have a good yield, because it's so jam-packed together. Oh God, it's good. This is great, this is great. And this I'm just going to take some from here. To do it with my fingers. Yeah, you can see, guys. So I have separated them, and now I'm just going to pour water on it. This is water. I get water on here like last night, and I try not to pour water over it. At the side, you pour your water. You can also pour water in this basin. You see right here in this basin, you can pour your water, because it's going to absorb the water. And here we go. So I have done the transplanting, because the plant was so chopped up. So I have separated it so it can have enough space for it to grow very well. That is it. Do not forget, if you want to do your transplanting, do not go pulling like this. If you go pulling them like this, it will break off, and that is it. It's bad. So you have to use something like this. You dip it so you... When you're doing your transplanting, you're transplanting it with the soil that it grew from. Can you see? With the soil itself. You cannot pull it off from the soil. You have to take it like this, in this fashion. You now separate two or three as you want, then you do your transplanting. That's how it goes. Do not forget. And that's it for today. Goodbye.